broadcasting live worldwide.
Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
10 seconds to go. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Many of us go to work each and every day. Some of us work anywhere between the hours of 40 hours a week to 60. Heck, I know some people that have worked up to 80 hours a week. When we're at work, we work with colleagues, coworkers. We see them more than we see our own families. Coworkers are family too. And that's what this episode is all about. Have Faith, Let It Begin starts right now.
On June 16th, 2018, a show designed for you, The Daily Commuter, went live. A weekly show all about faith. A show with motivational topics, inspirational stories, and personal testimony set out to change the world.
Hello, my name is Amari, and today we are back on another episode of Have Faith and Let's Begin.
Hi, my name is Isabella, and you're listening to Have Faith, Let It Begin.
Hi, I am Mia. You are listening to Have Faith, Let It Begin.
Welcome to Have Faith, Let It Begin. Here's your host, Angel Santana.
Can you say Have Faith, Let It Begin? Daddy loves you. Daddy loves you.
On this Wednesday, January 27th, 2021, Have Faith, Let It Begin starts right now. Hi, everyone. This is Angel Santana, and thank you for joining us. We want to welcome all our new subscribers and all of you that are on different platforms that are joining us for the first time today. Folks, you know, in the introduction, I meant what I said. Coworkers are family, too. You know, many of us work extremely long hours. Some of us work overtime. Some of us work hours that we can't even imagine. Some of us come home to, let's be honest, no one. Some of us come home to families, children, wives, husbands, nieces and nephews, uncles, aunts, grandparents, mothers and fathers. But let's talk about our family outside our family, our coworkers, those that we see more than we do our own families. Because let's be honest, with the amount of hours that we pull on a weekly basis, you kind of have to remember, this is your extended family. Something happened to me last week that I'd like to share with all of you. See, as many of you have listened on this show, and if you don't, let me just give you a little brief background. For 7 years, I worked for AAA New York. And in those 7 years, I created a bond, a friendship, with this crew that I used to work with. Primarily because we worked the same schedule. We took the same breaks, the same lunch. We used to have the greatest time. But unfortunately, after 7 years, many of us went our separate ways. Some have remained. Some have gone on to be with the Lord. And some of us continue to reach out to one another. I had the privilege of reaching out to the one person who I trained with and worked with for a very long time. Her name is Tanya. Tanya and I bonded the minute we met. There was just something that clicked, something that made sense. What I didn't know then, and I know now, is that we had a common friend. It was God. God brought us together. God helped me help her through her difficult times, and she definitely helped me through my worst times. Throughout the years of working with one another, we created this friendship, this bond. And as others joined in, like Ian, Camille, Suzanne, Monica, Tracy, Herbie, many of us together worked as a cohesive unit. All of us had great times together. We always shared in so many different stories and laughter. We hung out outside of work. We met for each other's birthdays. We had dinners. And last week, I had the opportunity to reach out to Tanya, who I had not seen physically since my wedding day, June 12th, 2015. But we had talked throughout the years, here and there, on and off. And every time we talk, it's as if we never missed a thing. Yeah, sure, we caught up about things that have gone on in our life that maybe we had forgotten to share with each other, but we pretty much knew what was going on in our lives. Recently, I reached out to Tanya, and we got talking, and we had some great laughs and trying to catch up a little bit, and we decided, hey, this conversation's been going on for an hour. I wish we could talk more. I wish we could have others join in. So, together, we created a AAA reunion chat. And within that chat, we started to talk to people. We started to reach out to one another. We started talking about people that we lost touch with, like Camille, who'd went on and many years earlier to better herself in her environment and, of course, in her career in the Carolinas. So we decided to come together and do a live Zoom chat. And we did. We got everything set up, ready to go for a Friday. And as funny as God is, God just knows how to create things. He knows how to put people in the right place at the right time. So Tanya and I spoke on a Thursday. We set up the reunion on a Friday night. Friday morning, I went to work. As I was at work, I took a call. A young lady on the other end asked for a couple questions regarding her father. And then she paused and said, "I'm sorry, did you say your name is Angel?" I said, "It is." "And your last name is Santana?" I said, "Yes." She says, "Angel, it's Camille." I literally was so happy to hear from her. Camille and I haven't spoken in a long time. We had spoken about Camille, Tanya and I, that night before. And I told her, "You would never believe what I have to share with you. We have been trying to reach out to all those that we worked with, and we want to do a live Zoom chat. I hope you will join us." And Camille was going through a hard time at that moment. Her father was very sick. So I'm reaching out to all of you real quick as I pause the story and ask you to continue to pray for Camille and her family and her father. Friday night, the Zoom chat opened up and Ian, Tanya, Camille, and I were able to join together. We spoke for almost an hour and a half and we had so much laughter. We had so much joy. We had an opportunity to think about what was happening in the now and forgetting about everything that was happening around us. For that, just that brief 90 minutes, it was as if the world was better again. Yeah, it was a good 90 minutes. Folks, coworkers are family. Yes. Families bicker, and so do coworkers. But I believe that all coworkers have the right place in their minds, in their hearts. Some will make mistakes. Some will do things that will regret their decisions. Others will choose to do things because their heart tells them to. Coworkers are people too. Coworkers are the closest thing to family within our own families. As you go to work today, think about your surroundings, your environment. Think about those that you work with on a daily basis. How well do you really know your coworkers? How much time do you take to know who you're spending time with? How often do you say good morning, good afternoon, and good evening? How often do you tell them, "Great job, it's always good to work with you"? How often do we think of the positive rather than the negative that they may provide? So this morning, as you travel to work, think about your coworkers. Even think about the ones that maybe you don't get along with. Find the positive. Find the good. Allow yourself the opportunity to know that the people that you're working with is not an accident. And you are there for a reason. We all serve a purpose. We all have gifts. We all have talents. We all have treasures. What gift, what talent, what treasure are you providing your coworkers, your extended family? What is a coworker? I miss my AAA family. I love my AAA family. I love all the years that I spent there. And I want to dedicate this show to all those that I worked with at AAA. May God bless you. May God keep you. May He shine His light upon you and grant each and every single one of you peace on earth. You will always have a friend, a brother in Christ here. Have faith. Let it begin. Thank you for listening to another episode of Have Faith, Let It Begin. That's right, Ariel. We're done with another show. And it's always great to have this show with you, my love. You know, we're going to encourage each and every person to listen to our show every single weekday. That's right, you and I are going to help change the world. Do you think that you can do that for me? Huh? Yeah, you know you can. She does. We want to let you know, and we encourage you to listen to our show each and every weekday, and it's going to be live at 7:30. Make sure you're subscribed to our show. Make sure you get ready, fasten those seatbelts, because Ariel and I and my family are going to bring you a new topic, a new story, each and every day, right? Isn't that right, Ariel? Yeah. And she's smiling at me. Guys, enjoy your day.